Hello, hello, everybody. It is 2:36 p.m. Central Time on the 12th of August, 2021. It's Thursday here in the United States. Got some breaking news for you. A 7.5 earthquake has just struck at the southeast portion of the South Sandwich Islands. You could just call this the southeast portion of the Pacific, even though it's tied to Antarctica. Down here, down southeast of South America, at the southeast tip. And we go back all the way across, and just yesterday we were dealing with a similar sized quake on the opposite side of the Pacific. A 7.1 to 7.2 quake struck yesterday, West Pacific. Now we're all the way down to the very southeast side again. Now this is tied to Antarctica. You can see how the plate comes down and goes over, but you see the fracture zones, they're connected directly across. So, this is the second 7-point-something earthquake in the last day. This is on top of the 8.2, the biggest earthquake in years, striking pretty much the halfway point between the two quakes up here in Alaska. If we go around the whole plate, halfway point going up and around, Alaska got struck with that 8.2 a week and a half, 2 weeks ago. Now we need to go check immediately to go see whether or not there is a tsunami warning or advisory. So let's just go ahead and close some of these windows here and open up tsunami.gov again for the third time in the last 2 weeks. I've had to check there. They have, look, they've got the quake, 7.6 to start out. They have info statements and a non-US Caribbean threat message. So let's go see what the threat message is. An earthquake with a preliminary magnitude of 7.6 occurred in the South Sandwich Islands region at 1833. Tsunami threat to the Caribbean region from this earthquake is still under investigation. Consider and prepare for the possibility of a tsunami threat to the Caribbean region from this quake. Now, again, that is just crazy. Now, let's go look at the stats on the quake. So first of all, there's the 7.5. We'll click it. It struck at 1714 UTC. Is that correct? No, 1832 UTC. Within the last hour. We'll just put it that way. Well, 1 hour ago, almost exactly. We'll go open the USGS info on this. There we are, 7.5 South Sandwich Islands. They do not have anything for tsunamis other than to take us over to the tsunami.gov, which isn't helping very much at all, other than to say that we have to watch and wait. Okay, let's go to the National Data Buoy Center. Again, this is the third time I've had to check in 2 weeks. This is unprecedented. Hey, look, we've got a buoy in event mode in the Gulf of Mexico. Buoy in event mode, Gulf of Mexico, what's going on there? Just detected. It's detecting the shockwave from that earthquake. Let's go view the event details. Here we are. Oh, yeah, look at that. So there it is. It detected an actual seismic wave on that. All the way up here, causing a buoy to go into event mode in the Gulf of Mexico off the coast of the United States, southern coast. If you're just now tuning in, a 7.5 earthquake has struck at the southeast portion of the what I would call the perimeter of the Pacific, even though it's technically tied to Antarctica. This was a topic of a joke I was cracking yesterday in my update. Well, here we are. We're at the very southeast side, and now the earthquake I'm looking for in Mexico has struck down here at the southeast tip of the Pacific, down at the South Sandwich Islands. Anyway, I'm not going to cancel the Mexico warning. It's just the East Pacific is moving now as a result of the previous shift. This is compensation movement on both sides of the plate. This is like the 20th time this has happened since I've been watching, that we see a big earthquake on one side of the Pacific, and then on the perimeter outside edge of the other, we get a similar sized quake within a day. And this happened previously several times, going back and forth from Japan to Ecuador, going back and forth from Solomon Islands to Mexico, and now we're going back and forth from Philippines to the South Sandwich Islands. Back and forth, the tennis match. Now the buoys in event mode going up into the Gulf of Mexico, but I'm not seeing any. Well, look, all the buoys are off. They're all off. All the ones in red, take a look at it. They're all off on the eastern side of South America. And we have nothing down there at the South Sandwich Islands, down to the south. Now, we have to wait for the speed of a jetliner, for an actual wave to show up, an actual physical wave in the ocean to show up, speed of a jetliner. So however long it would take a jet to fly from down here to up here, it would take hours and hours and hours, right? To go from down here to up here in a jet. So that's how long it's going to take for us to know whether or not there's an actual physical wave. But the seismic shockwave is at least spread to one station. That's so weird. Look at that. At least spread to one station in the Gulf of Mexico, but nowhere else so far. That's just so odd. An earthquake down here being responded to up here by one buoy. Well, there it is. So two sevens in the past 2 days. And twice I've had to check in the last 2 days for tsunami warnings, one of which was issued yesterday. Tsunami warnings over here in the West Pacific. And last week's tsunami warnings up here at the 8.2 quake off the coast of Alaska. You want to talk about going through it? We have new deep earthquakes that are popping off on our letter D's here. Letter D stands for deep earthquakes, and they're raised high off the globe so you can see them easily. So we're still getting them, and they're going now all the way over to Europe and all the way back over to South America. Three quarters of the planet having deep earthquakes down below a portion of the plate, followed by this kind of activity. Sevens all over the plate. Eights last week. Big increase. I hadn't had to check for tsunamis in months for the whole planet. And then all of a sudden in the past 2 weeks, we're checking over and over again. And we have multiple warnings that have been issued in the past 2 weeks. Alaska and Philippines. This one threat statement, gotta keep watch. Next few hours for the Caribbean all the way up here. Check it out. Another thing to think about. Why would the Caribbean be warned up here around the outside edge of South America from a quake all the way down here? Why? Why? Something's up. That's weird. And to get a buoy in event mode out there after the quake, how could this down here be connected to the Caribbean? Or to the Gulf of Mexico? How? These are questions I don't have an answer for. What if the flat earthers are right? What if this whole thing's twisted around? This comes around and bends around up to here and they connect it. And so an earthquake down here will affect up here because really, down here is up here. They're even with each other or something. And it's all BS and the globe is BS. I mean, it could be at this point. Aussies, check it out. New earthquake came rolling in here halfway across the plate. 3.2, but not at Uluru. On the north by northeast side of Uluru. Back down to it, 7.5 quake, right at the edge of the South Sandwich Islands, right at the southeast tip of what I would consider the edge of the Pacific. Now, of course, the professionals aren't going to agree with that, but again, this is the Pacific plate. This is Antarctica. We're at the southeast tip of Antarctica. I was cracking jokes about it yesterday because of what this looks like here. A foot, whatever that is, going up to the edge of the dong, and that's what I was joking about yesterday. Now it gets hit with a quake? Please. I mean, you want to talk about random spots that aren't random. Okay, back to it. Big quake, both sides of the plate, last 24 hours, basically. Tsunami warnings, pretty much with both of them, or at least one of them yesterday. This one, we're still waiting to find out if there's a tsunami warning. It's been over an hour, so we have to wait longer. There's no buoys all the way up. No way to know. Time to put some satellites up in space that can detect the movement of a wave over a large distance, wouldn't you think? You know, some kind of LIDAR, L-I-D-A-R, laser radar, basically, that can detect surface motion and be able to detect a few centimeters or even a few feet of a wave over a large area and be able to tell us whether or not there's a spreading wave from space. If there is such a thing as space, because again, we're going on the backside. And we have our quake down here affecting the Gulf of Mexico up here with nothing affected in between, which is super weird. I'm going to go ahead and save this as a video, but this is just phenomenal for us to get another seven after the eight, the seven, the seven. It's all around the planet. You got to understand, Alaska followed by Philippines, followed by the South Sandwich Islands on the opposite side of the planet, all in a week, basically, a week and a half, 2 weeks at the most, if you count the eight, that's big time movement going on. Not just a little bit, the whole planet shifting. And we know what's going on, why that may be happening overall. Solar activity started to go through the roof like 2 weeks ago, or a little bit more. So like 2 to 3 weeks ago, all of a sudden there's some big solar flare activity. Earth-directed solar flares, Earth-directed CME, strong solar wind. Okay, that all went down to the core of the Earth. And then it came back up with deep quakes. The pressure came back up and spread out and dropped off all these along the way. We are resulting from that big bombardment. And if there's any more that come in, you can increase where we are right now. Right now, we're on the edge of going up the next level. 7.2 yesterday on one side of the plate, 7.5 on the other side of the plate, and new deep earthquakes you can see on the screen here. Raised high off the globe, meaning more energy is being pumped in right now. Best case scenario, this spreads out with a bunch of sixes, and we're done with it. Best case scenario, as far as I can see, that we would connect between all these points with sixes and hopefully not hit any residential areas. But what more do you need? If you are paying attention, you already know that we're going up. I mean, the number of earthquakes and the power behind them. But if you're just a new random viewer or not normally paying attention, you're probably caught off guard by this. You're probably like, huh? What do you mean? There's a lot else going on right now. I don't really want to deal with it. Don't worry, guys. We can see this happening weeks out. Well, at least a week out. Anybody here already knew to expect this? It's kind of like a storm developing after you already know to look for two fronts coming together to form a storm. Like you're not shocked to see a storm form. Well, that's where we are. We're not shocked to see these big earthquakes strike. It's just somewhat alarming, it is, to see them strike back to back like that day to day. We're not talking about some huge geologic process time of months, years, or decades, or hundreds of years. We're talking about 24 hours shifting across the whole planet. All right, word up, much love, saving this as a video. Going to go premiere it over on YouTube. There's no tsunami warning right now. There's a threat watch level, which we have to wait hours, obviously. I just showed you the buoys. They're all redded out. They're all turned off all the way up the southern coast of South America. Yo! Man, I'm telling you, this is just, it's like the big quake over in the Philippines yesterday. They issue a tsunami warning, but they're got the buoys all turned off, and they even removed a lot of them from where they were. Like, got out of there. In the most earthquake-prone zones on the planet, where we need to know, all of a sudden, they're all off. If I was in charge of the operation, and I had them all off, what would you guys say about me? Again, I've been tasked with reporting the wave activity around the planet. We've done billions of dollars in funding to get these buoys placed all over the planet. And I'm responsible for them being on. And the big quake hits, and all of them are off, all the way up, on both sides of the Pacific, when two different earthquakes hit, 2 different days apart. What would you say to me? I know what you would say to me. You'd be like, Dutch, either get your act together or get the hell out of here. You're fired. That's what you would say to me. After two, yeah, you would say, I hope you would. If you didn't, there's something wrong with you. Not trying to lecture anybody. I'm just telling you. There it is. It's a crazy world we're living in. 7.5 earthquake striking the day after the 7.2 on the opposite side of the plate. We already knew to look for this. I made the professionals aware of this over 5 years ago. I showed this to the professionals. They mocked and ridiculed me, said it was chance and coincidence when I showed them, and the next day it happened again. So I showed them when Japan got hit in Kyushu, and the next day Ecuador got hit. Thousands of people killed between the two. I think Ecuador, maybe it was hundreds, either way. Lots of people killed. And I showed them, I said, hey, look, Kyushu has been hit in Japan. The next day, a 7 strikes down on the opposite side of the plate in Ecuador in South America. The professor came back, mocked and ridiculed me, said it was just chance or coincidence. The next day, after he said it was chance or coincidence, it went back and forth again. There was a 7 in the Solomon Islands at Vanuatu, and then the next day, a 6.9 over in Mexico. It was four different sevens that went back and forth when I tried to show the professionals however many years ago. Hey, they just shut me off. They just shut me off. Down in the lower right-hand corner, they just hit my internet. Shut me off. Bright red. Oh, yeah. I'm recording. You can go ahead and shut it off all you want, buttheads. I'm recording. And they can see your shut off. I'm on a fiber connection. I have 1,000 kilobytes available. And I'm, or, oh, well, no, I'm sorry, 100,000. And I'm using 6. I have 100,000 kilobytes per second available. I'm using 6. 6,000. 6 out of 100 is what I'm using. And there's the only way a shutoff could happen is if somebody gets my IP address and bombards my IP directly. And whose sites did I visit today? The USGS and the EMSC. Oh, and Volcano Discovery, but you know. So I visit the USGS site and all of a sudden my IP starts getting bombed when I'm talking about things that make them uncomfortable. Gee. We're going to save this as a video for everybody to see, and I'm going to go upload it over to YouTube, including the shutdown that they just tried to do right there at the end. Peace out, guys. Word up. The truth is going to prevail, and I'm not backing down.